Welcome to the Classy J Show. Usually I'll be more upbeat, but what I'll be talking about today is no laughing matter, no joking matter. It's very serious. At this time, if you haven't subscribed to the channel, please subscribe so you can receive all the updates on, you know, things going on with FreePG or going on with Classy J or just general news in general. Thank you for visiting, and I'll see you on the inside. Welcome, everyone. It's a very sad day for me today. Last night, T-Mobile, for the first time, I've had their service for a long time. Their service went out, and I was unable to receive calls. And while I was unable to receive calls, my husband was trying to call me. He thought that I just didn't care. Yesterday, I had wrote the warden of the prison that he was staying, and I said, well, my husband has been in your facility since March 31st, and I have not been able to see him. I sent the visitation paperwork. And it just rings, no one answers. I just want to know what is the process. If it's not you that I need to talk to, let me know who I need to talk to. I didn't hear anything back last night when I thought I didn't. Then I got an email from George telling me he's nervous. That facility is 2 hours away. It's in Orlando from where I live now. He said in the middle of the night they're going to take him to where they plan to have him for 25 years. And as I went to bed, towards the end of my work day today, I get an email. It's from the facility in Orlando where he was staying. And it was a classification officer. She apologized that, you know, I haven't been able to see him, but with the pandemic and when they're in the transition phase, they can't have visits. So the paperwork that I filled out, she said that will be transferred over to the next facility. And she's in her letter to me, she says, and by the way, your husband's removed. She gave me the name of the facility. The name of it is Santa Rosa Correctional Institution. I decided to look it up to see where it is. Before I tell you where it is, in the order, the judge who sentenced George said, you know, that he was not opposed to George being close to his family. Well, this institution 6.5 hours away from where I live. It's close to Mobile, Alabama. It's at the top part of Florida, west of Jacksonville. In order for George to get any visits, you know, he has to be on a pre-approved list. So someone would actually have to go download the forms or get the form, mail them in, and they'll do a background check. And if you pass the background check, then you'll be able to see him. Even if you were living in Georgia, to get to this facility, Santa Rosa Correctional, it is 5.5 hours from Georgia. He has started thinking. He has never been in trouble before, ever. This is his first offense. And on his first offense, either you know, for all these years, they just kept killing us, killing us, killing us. And nobody cared. There was nothing we could do. So finally, now, we got tired. Got tired of getting killed all the time. You know, we wanted to take justice into our own hands. And we got out there in peaceful protest. Little boy was having a conversation, you know, with a friend of his. The main character, the man in the Little Black Monkey. He says, "Sir, would you rather live to 50 and be white, or live to 100 and be black?" And the man looked at him. He didn't know what to say. He didn't even answer. He walked through the door. I'll tell you today, though, I still, if God gave me another chance, I would want to come back, and I would want to be the same thing that I am right now. I would want to be black. I just want the killing, the hurt, the pain, the mass incarceration, the unauthorized stops, the beating for my people to stop. George is officially a statistic. They give our black men, and to women too. So if you're not dead, you're in jail. I don't care what they do. I'ma get on my knees. If I have to get on my knees every night, pray to God to get him out of this. When he comes out, he's gonna have such a story. The story of how he overcame. The devil thinks that people praying, too many people believing, too many people hoping. I had to put this thing on. I don't feel pretty today. I just feel hurt for my husband. I just want to wake up from this bad dream. I'm going to go back to my wedding day. When he danced and he sang "My Girl" to me. the pain. I'm tired of the hurt. I'm tired of always being strong. I want to be real for change. I want to give him my strength. On my knees tonight and every night until God opened those doors. I know He will. I know He's really working it out behind the scenes. They gotta stop killing us. Stop mass incarcerating us and let us live like them. We're all the same. All lives matter. I do not have anything against any race. I just want to be treated equally. But the same crime that George is convicted of, some people don't get any time. They get plea deals. He was never offered a plea deal. It's as if the prosecutor just wanted another black man in jail for the rest of his life. He wanted to snuff his life out. County, inmate number 010734, and you will be connected to him. You can send him emails, video, if you like, you can send him, you know, money for his books. But he said it better than I did. Sometimes he just wants to hear from people from the outside. Because he says truly hell in there. And each email, note, or smile he receives from the outside gives him hope. And I'm asking you to give him hope.